One of my businesses is a site called wohello. We're a clothing shop where we do custom clothing. I'm wearing one right now, actually. I call this the Basquiat. It's embroidered, looks nice. And I got this question from Poles Fiction on Instagram. Hey Alex, your fangirl here. I need your expert knowledge about the fashion thing. How is the process of your t-shirt production from the idea to the drawing to the finished product? So today I want to talk about how do you turn an image into a vector? Because that is a key part of this entire process. And to do that, I have an entire pile of drawings here. Drawings. So what I want to do is pick one of these and we're going to turn it into a t-shirt. Let's do it. Step one, pick a drawing. Step two, pop it on the table, like so. Step three, grab a phone and take a picture. What we'll do here is airdrop it to me, like that. Very simple. And that will move this drawing in high def to the computer. Then it's going to be in downloads. This one's actually based on Robin Williams, believe it or not. So I'll call it red hair. So let's turn this into a vector so that we can use it for apparel and all of that sort of thing. I'll cover the second half of the process in a review of Printful, which is what we use to fulfill the orders, in a couple weeks. So make sure you subscribe if you want to check that one out. A vector, if you don't know, is a digital image, which instead of being drawn at a certain resolution, which means if you zoom in, it'll get pixelated, like I'll show you right now. If I zoomed in on this, it's kind of blurry. It's kind of pixelated here. If you printed this on a shirt, you would see these pixels and it would really make the shirt seem low quality. So what we're gonna do by turning this into a vector is make this digital. It'll allow us to clean it up a little bit too. You see how there's some scraps here, and I'll remove this part and then it'll be much easier to put it on a shirt. So let's do that. This is my favorite autotracer. And so let's try it out. Red hair, pop it into autotracer. And it's very easy here, no reduction in colors. Turn it into an SVG, which is a vector. And so here's redhair.svg. Then we'll open this in Adobe Illustrator. So as you can see, the image is a vector now. It looks pretty similar to how it did before, but it is a vector, and actually you can zoom in and you see that each part now is a drawing, and I can actually delete little parts of this, which is cool. Now let's flip it so it looks normal. Basically what I'm doing is just going through and deleting every part of this that isn't black or red. So I'll get back to you in a few minutes after I've cleaned this entire thing up, and then we'll see the image as a vector. So I went through and I deleted a lot of the off-white space. And what we're left with is this vector. I could go through and clean it up a little bit more, like delete some of these spots in here. This is basically what I was doing. It took a few minutes, maybe 10 minutes, 20 minutes to do this. That's it. Image is a vector. So we'll show you the zoom in test here. And it doesn't matter how far we zoom in, you're not going to get pixelation because it's a vector. We did it. Woohoo! If you like this video, I'd love if you would share it with a friend you think would also get value. If you want to grab this shirt, we'll link down in the description. And part two, I'll talk about how I actually turned this into a t-shirt using Printful. Like the video if you liked it. Comment if you want to see anything else or if you have a better way. I'm Alex Berman. Thanks for watching.